difficult crimes to solve is one with no motive and often little evidence. It's a hit and run.
In the upstate, the South Carolina Highway Patrol says there are well over a dozen unsolved cases in the last few years. 7 News' Diane Lee explains how you can help bring an end to the agony that so many victims' families feel when they don't have answers in this 7 News original report.
The sight of a roadside cross may instinctively slow you down.
It just reminds everybody that he died here, to be careful here.
But for many of the families who erected them, life is at a standstill as they wait for answers.
My plea is that the people that do know who hit my son would come forward.
Tina McGinnis lost her 16-year-old son, Isaiah, October 13th of 2014.
I pounded the floor and screamed and said, why, Lord, why, you know, and just no.
A driver in a 1990s black over silver Lexus LS400 sedan hit him when he was crossing Whitehorse Road near Lily Street at 5 a.m.
It's hard. He was my best friend.
The loss more recent for Ashley Toller, whose brother Cody died when a white or silver pickup truck hit him this past New Year's Day on Highway 86 in Anderson County at 1 a.m.
I want to get justice for him. Like, we didn't get to have the closure that we need.
Toller and McGinnis are part of a growing number of upstate families whose loved ones were killed by drivers who left the scene. Since 2014, Highway Patrol says there are 13 unsolved hit-and-run cases spanning Anderson, Greenville, Pickens, and Spartanburg counties, all of those fatal. By far, the greatest number, 8, have been in Greenville County. And those numbers don't include non-fatal unsolved hit-and-runs, like the cyclist who was hit October 15th on Woodruff Road. Ben McCall, still hospitalized with brain and spinal cord injuries after he was rear-ended by a driver in a burgundy car near Anderson Ridge Road in Simpsonville. Highway Patrol released this sketch of the driver, who has still not been caught.
Sometimes we don't have enough evidence to put that charge on someone. So our MAKE team investigates a lot of these hit and runs. They're very thorough. They're very good at what they do. If there's anything that we can do that will lead us to solve these cases, you know, we're going to track it down.
Which is why Highway Patrol brought these unsolved crimes to our attention, hoping you would come forward with any information that could help solve them.
The Tollers have raised money for a $3,000 reward.
I just hope it makes people out here realize that we're not giving up.
There's no way.
And neither is McGinnis. Without answers, 4 years might as well have been yesterday.
You think each year it'd get easier? It just gets a little harder. How can you hit another human being and then just keep driving? I don't understand.
In the upstate, Diane Lee, 7 News.
Well, we know we can't possibly cover the details of all 15 unsolved hit and runs in the upstate in this story, but we've posted all of those flyers at WSPA.com.
And that's where you can see the details and possibly help those families get answers.